Sorry about the problems we're having with the main event tonight. One of those things, Julius Francis ain't here. So we crack on with Ojay Abrahams against Kevin Thompson. This is a light welterweight contest, 6 3-minute rounds. Ojay, we have seen many times before, good friend of Pro Box, always 100% good value for money, always a pleasure to have him on the show. But first, let's say hello to Kevin Thompson. Kevin Thompson coming off a six-round points defeat against Jeff McCreish, who we saw a little earlier on the show, stopping Vince Rose in four rounds. Former kickboxer. Weight advantage over Ojay. Often campaigns as a light middle, but we shall see when John Mortimer gives us the weights. So there is Kevin Thompson.
The one and only Watford's number one, me, myself, and I.
This is an unexpected bonus for Ojay, because he didn't honestly expect to get on the live part of the show tonight. Watford Football Club's number one fan. Sure would be delighted that Graham Taylor's back at the club. And delighted too that his son Cassius will have the chance to watch the old man on the box tonight.
This is how we do. Always looks in tremendous shape. He's actually been dieting the last week to get down to a certain weight for tonight's fight, and then of course comes in against a late replacement in Kevin Thompson, and a very good one on that too. It's a good fight tonight.
Well, there's Ojay. Must be near a Southern Area title shot if he comes through tonight, okay. So, there we are. And here's John.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest is in the welterweight division. Firstly, and introducing to you, fighting out of the red corner and wearing the blue trunks, and he's from Wolverhampton and weighing in at 10 stone, 13 and a half pounds. Would you please welcome Kevin Thompson? And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, he's wearing the black trunks and weighing in at 10 stone and 11 pounds. Would you please welcome from Watford, me, myself, and I, Ojay Abraham. Your timekeeper is Mr. Tom Rice. Your referee is Mr. Mark Green. And this is 4 3-minute rounds of boxing.
Thompson. You're both professional boxers. When I tell you to fight, stop boxing, step right back, and don't throw no punches as I tell you to box on. Both of you, protect yourselves at all times. Shake hands, gentlemen, good luck.
So this, once upon a time, was scheduled for six, now comes down to four threes.
Shows up.
And I thought Kevin Thompson might have a little bit more weight advantage, 10, 13 and a half to 10, 11, a couple of pounds. I have to say, it does look more to me, Nicky.
Yes, obviously, naturally, he's a much bigger man. He's certainly much taller. Oh, Ojay, we know, can punch either hand.
Well, it looks, there does look a weight division between them, I've got to say.
Don't hold, still get out. Give yourselves room, punch away.
and healthy respect from both of them.
A little too healthy, I feel, for a four-rounder, Dave.
And he's got him. That was a good shot.
Delayed effect. It was a tremendous shot.
5, 6, 7. I can't wait to get at him. Up at 8.
Over there.
And he means business now, OJ. Got caught himself.
Needs to take his time, pick the shots. A very accurate, uppercut started it.
Punch away the pair, yeah? Pull your arm down, OJ. Punch away the pair, yeah?
OJ needs to work to make this a 10-9 round, really.
Well, I feel he let slip the opportunity there, OJ. Well, the two major wins he's had in his career against Darren Dyer and Errol MacDonald came early. And you figure that the best opportunity he has is going to be early against Kevin Thompson.
This was a superb shot, very accurate. Look at that, to the side of the head, delayed action. And this is another angle. Here we see, leans back, great shot. And Kevin Thompson thought better of it. Was in trouble, needed that few seconds rest.
10 seconds, corners.
Tight. Come on, let's get with this. Okay. Faint and fetch the other one.
Same job.
Okay, now do it.
Two.
Do it.
Come on, Yoni.
Second round then. Abrahams, the shorter of the two. With the white boxing boots, they're both wearing black trunks with a red trim. Abrahams with the Professional Boxers Association badge on the left leg of his trunks.
Well, Thompson very wary of the power of OJ Abrahams, but I feel he's starting to outbox him now. OJ's falling short with these hooks. Hasn't got a bad jab himself, should start using it.
We've seen it on Pro Box. OJ has retired and come back more often than Frank Sinatra over the last 9 months to a year. Yeah, he's retired 3 times and come back 3 times. Would love a title shot.
This guy is a lot bigger naturally, as we've already said, than OJ, and OJ is finding it difficult to pass these long arms. Good left hook.
OJ's got to keep it close, or else he's just going to get picked off.
And he has been picked off so far. He's losing this round on my card. At the moment, needs to work hard this last minute.
That's better from Ojay. He's measuring it. He's got to get in. He's got to take that half step close up. If he affords Thompson too much respect, he's just going to get his head jabbed off.
Like that. And he's very, very upright when he comes in attacking. If Thompson started to use some hooks of his own, he may start hurting Ojay.
Like that. Oh, no, Joe's taking shots now. This is good stuff from Thompson. Back comes Abrahams. This is a tear-up now.
Well, this is what he needs.
Bell came just at the wrong time for the pair of them. Well, he's one of the matchroom boys now, is Ojay. George Patrick, Jason King in the corner with him.
Well, sporadically, Ojay worked quite well inside. This was towards the end of the round, and a good left hook. Well, that's what he needs to do, apply the pressure and get inside those long arms of Thompson. Thompson came back strongly himself. Oh, caught with a good right uppercut from Ojay. I actually gave that round to Thompson there, though, Dave.
Stand up, round three.
Yeah, I'd go with that. So one apiece on my card. Don't forget that Thompson down briefly in the first. You saw the shorts colours, both in the black and red.
Well, he's hit Thompson in the eye, and Thompson can't see. It was just a plain jab.
Five, six, seven.
No, and the eye is gone, and that's a good win for Abrahams. It came with desperate swiftness, and it's the nose. The nose has just gone. Ojay threw the ropes. Ojay, if Cassis is listening, Ojay says he's coming straight home, and Kevin Thompson is in big trouble. That shot broke his nose, Nicky.
It did. The nose is profusely bleeding. It didn't even seem that hard, to be honest with you, but I suppose if the punch catches you correctly on the right spot, you're going to go down and get it, as we see there, broken nose.
Yeah, that goes down as a third round knockout, and this is what happened.
Oh, pushed the nose right up, didn't it?
Yeah. And that was, well, that's the. I think that's the only time you'll ever see a knockout with a jab.
Yes.
It was just the angle that it was caught. It just.
It just
crumpled the nose, and Kevin Thompson just collapsed in agony, which is cruel luck, because he was edging ahead, and it was still anybody's contest. But good win for Ojay. Against a man who had a superior record to his, and you never know, that much-wanted Southern Area title shot could be getting ever nearer. John.
Ladies and gentlemen, 35 seconds of round three. Referee Mark Green stopping the contest. Your winner, me, myself and I, Ojay Abrahams.
So there we go, Ojay gets it.
For the loser, Kevin Thompson, ladies
leans
and gentlemen.
Over, says hello. He loves everybody now. As indeed to most fighters who win. We're going to take a break, and I'll have some news for you about what's going on when we get back. So good win for Ojay. Tough luck on Kevin Thompson to suffer that nose break, but that's the way it goes. We're going to take a short break. Stay with us. We'll be back with more action on Pro Box in just a moment.